The experience I had with Palm, I realized that the effect on me as a consumer and as a developer basically was enough to persuade me that patents were not so positive. I got exposed to the whole notion of the United Kingdom Intellectual Property. It's called the Intellectual Property Office, the UKIPO, and it's actually it's a very intriguing name because they use the word intellectual property, which was pretty new to me at the time as a skeptic. I mean, I was aware of the term, but I never really thought about it and what it was intended to do. So what they try and convey is a state of affairs where ideas of property, you know, like something physical that you pass around and you sell to people, weird, I suppose. I know it's intellectual by default, even though many of these things are trivial and they're being taught, or just a combination of things, as I'll explain later what I mean by it's not so intellectual and many of these things are pretty trivial. The skepticism I had led me to as a Linux user for a very long time, I basically saw all kinds of situations developing with Microsoft, especially with the Novell deal in 2006, where they said, well, Novell will pay us a fee to use Linux. And I thought, well, what is it for? And they couldn't even name the patents. It wasn't about patents that I could see actually before me. It's anything specified. It was just a big pile of patents, and Novell has to pay Microsoft for it, which means that I, as at a time a SUSE user, would have to pay Microsoft to use SUSE, which is really strange and very insulting, to be honest. So I got very much into that. I got involved in the Boycott Novell thing, as people still probably know me by this one project. And I'll explain in the next video, next part of the video, I guess, what exactly I was trying to address and why I think we are right to fight software patents in general.